Hello friends, welcome. Now let us take a new case of LPP. We are going to solve it by simplex method, and every time I try to find a question in which something new is there. In the first problem which we solved through simplex method, we had compared the solution process of simplex method and graphic method by drawing a sketch of graph. In the second problem which we solved through simplex method, we had two inequalities with greater than or equal to sign in case of a maximization problem, but with only one variable, and we learned how to simplify the problem and to form a revised problem which is very easy to solve even through simplex method. In this method also, friends, we have a small but new point, but let us start the simplification of the problem. As the solution will go further, the facts and surprises will unfold themselves, and you will come to know what is the new thing in the solution of this problem. One small thing is negative sign, but that is not a greater thing in itself. But whenever you face a negative sign in any of the inequalities, be alert. Including myself, we all are, say, liable to do mistakes when we face negative sign. Okay? Yes. Now we have three inequalities with less than or equal to sign, which is in direct matching with the objective of maximization. In all these three, we will have to add slack variables. So the revised form of the problem with equalities will be maximize z equals to 5x1 plus 2x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 subject to. (4x1 + 2x2 + s1) = 16. Second will be 3x1 + x2 + s2 = 9, and the third will be 3x1 - x2 + s3 = 9. Now we have five variables: x1, x2, s1, s2, and s3, all are non-negative. So this is the same problem now in the form of equalities instead of inequalities. Now we can solve this problem. And yes, friends, it is my suggestion, whenever we solve any linear programming problem having two variables in it by simplex method, you please solve the same problem in your graph book through the graphic method, and always compare the solutions of graphic method and simplex method. That will be very helpful to you in understanding the simplex method. Thank you. In the next video lecture, we are going to prepare simplex table 1 of this problem.